All right. Here we go for round two with the squad. Now, if you're going to catch the first video, but we attempted some rear brakes, and that was a fail because the pins were rusted right on there so bad you could not get them off. Now I'm going to give it a shot at the front brakes. See if this goes any better. There's like two slide pins. Not sure exactly how these come off. I've never done brakes. I bought this old. There's like 212 caliper off, but then I'm not sure what you do after that. I've never worked on one this old. And of course, this requires a socket and I got a wrench. So, alright. Give the compressor noise in the back there around. But on Eugene's backyard repair, sometimes we get a little sophisticated and use some air tools. Alright, we'll be back. Alright, there we go. I'm gonna go ahead and grab me a 12mm socket. Of course the brake line's right in the way. Where else would I expect? Get the bottom one broke loose. Top one. I have to use a wrench on this. Of course, some engineer decided to put the brake line right in front of it. This guy. We'll get this one off. And the holder. One of the magnetic. Change your things here, the trays. Oh, this one should be fun. CC's right to the caliper. Of course, I had a screwdriver in the left. Oh, CC's hard. Yeah, I don't even know how this one was turning. Maybe it does have front brake. Maybe it just seized up solid. Alright, we're gonna have to get the caliper to go in. Look and see what I can pry against here. Hopefully something that won't work. She moves a little bit. Push the hammer away. I put everything away. Alright. You have to pause you here. I gotta go get some better tools. Here we go, see if we can get the sucker to come on. I can see this. No brakes are left at all. Oh, this is going to be a fun one. Everything's seized. Slides are seized. Should be fine. Oops, not a break. Oh, I'm gonna call it a break. Clean some stuff up here. Don't seem to still be working. Working still. The piston's prone. Before you end the piston, she's a keeper up. We're gonna go get the clamp, see if we can in the cup around the back here. See if you squeeze it back down. See what happens. She's a bad one. I'll go get it. Go get the clamp on the back. Alright, we're back. Got myself a welder's clamp here. Usually works out pretty good. Bring this down. Inside the cup here. On the back. Pressure. Okay, good, Sammy. Let's see what happens. Now you got water in the piston. I'm sure I'm on this plug of seeing perfectly seeing inside. Clamp up a little bit more and give it another squeeze. Shock it a little bit. Alright. I'm gonna do what I don't want to do. Squeeze that. Squeeze that front brake and see if it comes out of them. I can let this loose. Something pops. Squeeze it for a couple seconds here. Give it a shot. Yeah, no, it moves. Got any rust on that cylinder. Think we might pop them either. Give it a little. Of course, I didn't bring anything to pop the lid. That's normal. Put you in place, Chris. You never fail. Face it away from me here. Recently, tighten it back up. Good job. Good job. There she is. She's lots of water. Down here. Okay. Well, now I'm gonna take one down. Way down. Yeah. Full of dirt and water. Okay. Awesome. Whatever. Eject the spider. Bring it back up. Or if we get it, hold it on the ground here. Yeah, the brake fluid was no good. Get rust. Oh, it's terrible. Terrible. I'm trying to get the cylinder out again. Put it back in. Towards the top this time. There's nothing to do here. I think we got it coming to the top that time. I think we backflushing this system. Oh, nothing backflushing. I think we'll mine off our gear now. I just run fresh fluid through the shop until it comes up clear again. Pop this bleeder and find out. Yep. Don't seem to be anything coming back up. Trying to get the indication of the clamp brake line. Some brake clamps, clean this up, and get loose of the brakes on here. These weren't terrible. I mean, they didn't be cheap, but they weren't terrible. Get some new brakes on here. Alright. And pause yet, and I'll be right back. Alright, we're back. Little brake cleaners here. Of course, a backyard repair person was using brakes over on the other side, but. Step behind me, smoke. Yeah, I'm gonna step in. Wire brush to clean up some stuff here. Put it all clean. Mmm, yummy. Work cleaner. Not my favorite. Alright, let's grab this thing. Alright, we're on the other side. Some backyard brainiac forgot to press record. That's okay, you missed all the fun stuff on the other side. I'm trying to put the brakes on upside down. I'm sorry, not upside down, but backwards. Yep. I was mad when I did it, and I said, oh well, I recorded it so it'll be funny. Because I didn't record it. Sorry about that. We'll see if this side is just as big of a fight as the other side was. Of course, we'll have the same problem with this top bolt. You can't get the ratchet in there. The brake line's right on top of it. Might be losing the brake line hose. Yep, all I had to do is move it up just a hair. So behind it here, so don't go right back to where I was. Alright, let's give it a shot. Oh yeah, not much easier. If you get the right on there, it'd be easier. Oh, there we go. You got it at an angle. Yeah, that didn't work for long. Now I forgot to break my ring. I'm gonna just leave the bolt right in the hole. Nope, that fell out. Of course, here we're gonna show you some nice bushings here. don't think there's anything left in inside of these. What do you want from 1990? All right. Oh, this one's tough just like the other side. Awesome. Awesome. You think I would have a technique jam? Nah, you're wrong. Attention this time, Gene, so I'm on the right way. These ones can't know any better. These weren't too horrible. I mean, they had to be changed, but. Much easier. My clamp here. Get some brake clean on this, clean up. I should scoop up there. I do have a screwdriver. Enough hay in here to bail something. One thing is the airline's right here next to me. And the air gun's right here. Sense. This is a brass brush, so I gotta put the metal or the rubber actually. Get any dirt around the top here that might push into the seal. Looks like a D40. Of course, the grass is still stuck in there. I guess this side has as much rust as the other side did. No, I moved. This one moved. No point. Not enough. I'm gonna change the fluid anyway on this. I'm gonna pull both lines right off the calipers, and I'm gonna pull the line. Stick it for a second here. I'll pull the line off right here and I'm gonna blow air and get all the fluid back out of this line. So let me hear you're still facing out the caliper. Yeah, close enough. Alright, let's see if we can loosen this bleeder without getting bricks within my eyes. But don't worry, if I do, you won't see it because you won't see my face anyway. Alright, here we go. Oh my gosh, that was some dirty, dirty fluid. Give me a little more squeeze here. Yeah, she's empty now. Good. Brake cleaner. Brake fluid will take the paint right off stuff if you leak it long enough. Did you bring the other brake, would you? No! Why would you? Oh, let's see from up there. Don't worry, there's another four-wheeler sitting right behind me about 10 feet, little TRX. I think that one's an 88, 125. And on the back of it, voila, new set of Caltrick. Not really good, but I think they were kind of mid on the price range. Caltrick brake shoes. Oh, let's try using the hole this time in the bag instead of just ripping it. These brakes are original. You little WD-40 here, rag. That's an OEM original brake shoe. 1990, and it still was actually good. But if you watch my video for the rear brakes, which will come out before this one, you'll see why the front ones were so good, because they abused the heck out of the back ones. There was nothing left. The inside one, I don't think there wasn't even a plate. But of course, that rear brake didn't come out so good. It kind of had some oops, something broke. So I gotta buy parts for that. So you have to catch my I broke it video, and then catch my next video where I update it. Some new caliper and brackets and whatever else. Rear brake line, brake cable. That's how I get in my face. Sorry about the noise. Alright. Bridge, set the brake chute in. Down to my knees. Get the inner one in. Right direction. Like I said, I wish I would have touched record on the outside of you. Somebody have been going, what the heck is this guy doing? Put the brake chute in, bro. That's what I'm doing. It was just for fun. This side. This side. These pins are awesome. Awesome. Mud. Here. Yeah, mud, not rust, just mud and gunk stuck to them. Whoa, isn't it nice when you put stuff on the right way? Turn that a little bit. The socket of my, or the socket of extension on myself. Do a separate video on the brake line flush. You know, I missed that. There's some interesting stuff gonna come out of that line. What did you do? Move the other one? Of course, you could move the caliper too. To get closer. This line out just a touch more. Let's keep it right here for the. Didn't seem to want to stay. That's my little tiny bar. 20 feet of it. Sure that. Well, I don't even know why I worried. I'm gonna take him off anyway. I don't know if I'm gonna do it today. I'm kind of hungry. Time to eat. Move the brake line and then use a wrench. Or we use a ratchet. Oh, look at that. There she did. Ran into the brakes. One ones back in the box. Should keep one of these and stick it on the wall. Nobody believed this had the OEM brakes in it. 1990. Unbelievable. I think even the rear brakes were EBC, so they were changed. So just the front ones are OEM. Alright man, that's the end of this video. Eugene's backyard repair. Thank you for watching. Like, share, subscribe, tell your friends. Hopefully get some more followers soon here. Do what I can do. You can follow me on Instagram, Eugene's Backyard Repair. Let's put this up a little bit so you can see me. Yep, Eugene's Backyard Repair on Instagram. I post videos. I'm going to post a couple pictures of them rear brake shoes. They're on the back of the quad. But I'm posting pictures of them rear brake shoes. Somebody get their money out of them. We'll think about maybe we're going to want to rear brake this too, but I'm not sure if the pads are so cheap.
Yeah. This doesn't have any big deep grooves into it, so seemed like the mill wore nice and flat. But, anyway, thank you for watching. Peace.